Today, we are taking a look at the new outpainting feature available on OpenAI's text-to-image platform, DALL-E. So if you have access already, it looks like you simply click upload an image, and you can select any image you want, but it's going to make it square. So here I've got a piece of artwork I've made that is a wireframe, and I'm selecting it to see how it deals with the intricacy of some of the wireframing. And I've seen in some scenarios people erasing part of the image, which I know is necessary, I think, for the typical editor. But here we'll explore erasing, and then we'll explore not erasing and see what the difference is. Some different tools at the bottom here. This one is the selection pane for the generations that will fill in the gaps. And it looks like it wants you to overlap a good portion of the image. And here there's a little snippet explaining that. It says, you know, to overlap so that it can grab basically some samples from the remaining image. And here in the text prompt box, we will start typing something for it to generate, and we will do an astronaut floating in outer space. And let's see, with a fluid wireframe grid, and hopefully that sort of samples what we have. It samples part of the image, and let's see what it comes up with. So I'm just going to click generate. Just for your reference, this video is sped up, so some of the rendering times are shown a little quicker than they might be for you, but they are pretty quick in general. Okay, so this is pretty nice, and it looks like there's some toggles here at the bottom that allow you to kind of flip through. You get four different images that it generates, and it's totally at your discretion what you want to choose, what fits the image best. So some of these are pretty good. I like some of the detail on this, but that one I think might be the best. But we'll just kind of flip through one more time to confirm, and then when you're ready to accept, it looks like you just simply click this accept button, and then you are ready to move on. So I'm going to try and build sort of a 16x9 image here. So I didn't see any tools that give you a good kind of aspect ratio frame of reference, so we're just going to sort of build it out and then download some samples as we go. So here we're moving the crop box, the generation frame, and let's put in glowing stars in outer space with fluid wireframe. See if it kind of picks up and continues off of the wireframe theme, but adds some of the new prompts. So I'm liking the detail here. It looks really nice. It's definitely taking on the wireframe prompt and, you know, using the sample. So here, let's take a look at these options. They're okay. Not quite exactly what I was imagining, but just for the sake of time and moving forward, let's keep moving this box around and filling in the gaps. Up here in this left corner, let's do a rocket ship. It's two words, rocket ship in outer space with a fluid wireframe grid. I don't know if the fluid wireframe is working. Let's do fluid abstract wireframe grid. See if we get something a little more unique looking, but hopefully still applicable to the image. And then, I'm also overlapping not as much here, so let's see how it kind of takes the samples from that. So the tools, you can pan around, you can zoom in and out using the plus and minus in the right bottom right hand corner. So it's nice to be able to zoom in and kind of explore what's being generated here at a finer detail scale. That rocket ship is not what I was imagining, but it did grab onto the wireframe nicely on the existing image. So let's flip through here, see if we find something we like. We got some text popping in there. Also not what I was imagining, so definitely not gonna do that. I like this rocket ship. Kind of fits in the image nicely, frames out the left-hand corner. So let's keep moving forward here. I'm just gonna overlap this top part. And let's see, again, the more you overlap the original image, the more it'll rebuild that area. So just be careful. I think in this first sample here, I'm just gonna try to see how it fills this in, but I'm afraid it's gonna lose some of that gap there. So actually, let's just bump this up, and we can always crop the image after we download it out and crop it in Photoshop or something. So that's a good area, and let's see, what do we want to do here? Maybe just delete that, and fluid abstract wireframe grid, black hole. That was sort of the theme of the original image, so I'm curious to see, I guess, what that will produce. So I'm going to overlap the base image and see if it kind of picks up on what I had there, or if it generates something entirely new. Just curious to start off by seeing that first. So this is sort of the gist of the tool, and so let's see here. Okay, it's giving me, oh, you know what? I think it actually took the rocket ship prompt. Okay, so I did notice that this happens. If you select the box, the generation frame box, after you've already typed in a prompt, it'll pick up the previous prompt. So just be careful about that. I'm just gonna move it back up here, because it looked like it was changing too much of my original image. And let's just simplify the prompt and kind of fill in this top area. So, okay. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, it kind of looks black hole-ish. And it's not modifying too much of the original image there. But let's give it another go here. I'm just going to remove the black hole, I think, and let it just kind of play off the fluid abstract wireframe grid, which is what the original image is. And I don't want it to modify too much up in this area. So, okay, yeah, these look a little more simplified, which I think are to my liking. So just, again, for the sake of kind of moving things forward, let's just select one and move forward with it. So see, I selected the grid and it keeps the previous prompt there. So when I move it this time, let's see. Let's modify this a little bit. Let's say fractal wire frame trees in outer space. I have no idea what this is gonna produce, but let's give it a go. again, I mean, I think it's a good idea when you start this process to have an image or kind of an idea of the scale that you want, the ratio, the size, the things you want to implement, or if you're totally going for an organic kind of transitional fluid theme, that works too. Okay, I don't like any of these images, so that one's not bad. I thought there's some leaves and things hanging out here, but let's cancel that. Let's just take this tree out. I don't think I'm really digging the fractal. Maybe the fractal is too much. Let's just see wireframe tree and see what that produces. So like I was saying, I think if you have an idea of like the image type, you can really be concise with what you're trying to produce here. Otherwise, you can really get lost, I think, in exploring. So there it gave me something kind of simple. I'm just gonna use that and move forward. Let's go down here in this bottom and let's get a little geometric orb. Geometric floating orb. Yeah, I don't know if that's gonna help or not, but kind of just want to see some balls kind of floating in space here that have some wireframing on them. Again, so I originally chose the wireframe image because I wanted to test how it was dealing with sort of the detailed nature of the wireframing, and it looks like it's doing a really good job. That's a pretty good orb. Let's just move the box and see if we can kind of continue marching along with these geometric floating orbs. So I'm not quite sure if this aspect ratio is 16:9. It does not look like it, so we might have to build out a little more on the edges here. These are some good orbs. But I think, yeah, these are nice. I like the varying scales. So I'm going to download this image and give it a test, and we'll see what it looks like. Okay, so I just tested it off screen, and it was nowhere near 16:9. I should have known. But again, this video is sped up here just so that, you know, I'm not wasting your guys' time and watching these things render out here. But I'm going to fill in the image with a little more of this sort of luminescent particles spraying. Spiraling, twisting. I don't know, just see if we can get something kind of dynamic in the corner here. And again, you know, if you have sort of a deliberate mission for the image, it's a little unfortunate that they don't have aspect ratios that you can kind of play within. You kind of are just exploring, and maybe that's the point of the tool, is they want you to just have the freedom to continue building out and maybe just crop on an as-need basis. But I can definitely imagine the tool expanding to have some more Photoshop type capabilities. It would be really interesting if this actually became like a plugin for Photoshop or vice versa. But you know, as for now, certainly this tool is going to be growing here on this platform with more tools. And I can imagine you know, having aspect ratio being one of them. Better saving options is another thing. They warn you that you should save often, which is that that down arrow with a line underneath it in the top right hand corner underneath your profile icon. And so, you know, I had been doing that periodically throughout this, just to ensure. They say that if it does crash, you can re-upload the image wherever it was and start from there. So that's just a good reminder, like any program, save often. So the remainder of this video, I'm just filling in the edges here with some similar types of prompts that kind of keep in theme with the image. I'm probably gonna end up using this image as the thumbnail for this video. Definitely has a fluid, abstract look to it, which I'm liking. It's definitely playing off of the original image and went in a direction that I don't think I would have produced on my own, so it's fun. Oh, I like these floating kind of particles that sort of look parametric in the corner there. That's nice. Let's see if we can get something similar in this side panel here. Let's generate that again. So curious to see your guys' iterations, your thoughts, your experiments. This is nice. Okay, I'm liking this. Let's see here. Ooh, okay. This is very nice. Definitely some interesting results. Again, something that I don't even know how I would go about creating that if it was just in Photoshop, or the original line work was actually created in SketchUp. Really fond of that program for the precise kind of geometric nature of it and having the control of the geometry. So the wireframe came from that, but I think a lot of artists are exploring these AI tools that can take them places they never would have been able to go, because they either don't have the skills, the rendering skills, the modeling skills. So it's an interesting time to see so many artists gain access to the ability to draft and create these types of images, these fluid forms and kind of abstract mashups between very contrasting places and things. So we're definitely seeing an expansion in the field of artistry, which is always good because it pushes you. And there's a lot of discussion about, you know, who's the author of a lot of these images or the ideas that are being produced. And many people think that everything should be available to everyone, since, you know, the images that it's drawing from is a collective database of images that people may have or may not have consciously opted into, which is definitely, you know, up for debate. And I think there's a lot of philosophy surrounding that. Okay, these are some really weird UFO options. I'm not liking that at all. So I think we gotta switch this out here. Let's see, go back to just wireframe of a UFO. And let's see what, if it gives us something a little more in theme with the rest of the image. But again, I'm really liking this image. I can't say I'm the author of it completely. I'm definitely, you know, putting prompts in. Okay, I don't really like any of these either. Let's see, let's just change this one more time to like a satellite. That might get us something that's less cartoony looking. yeah, like I was saying, definitely don't feel like I'm the complete author. I'm just typing in words here and seeing what's coming up, and you get a selection of images, and you know, you get to choose what your favorite one is. So these are like very collaborative images, I think, you know, based on the AI's input. So one other thing I'll touch on real quick is the credits that this uses. It looks like they're qualifying it as the same as you know, a typical generation. So every time you generate an option for some of these edits, it is costing you what a typical credit would cost you. So I think that's, you know, one credit per generation here. In the corner, I was kind of struggling to get something that I liked to fill the space. There were letters coming in. I finally got a decent image of a satellite. Again, I think, you know, learning how much you need to overlap, where to overlap, if you need to erase or not, you know, these are things that you can just kind of explore on your own. But I definitely understand, you know, the caution in wasting credits while you're doing this. So that's why I would advise, you know, having a mission in mind for your first attempt, because it can definitely get a little out of control. I think I must have run like, you know, 20, 25, maybe 30 iterations throughout creating this image. And if you had a more precise plan in place, you know, you might be able to get away with fewer generations. But it also depends on how much detail you want, how big you want the image to be. So it looks like this is gonna sort of round out my image here. I'm pretty pleased with the overall graphic. Just remember to download it, just to keep it you know, saved and downloaded. You can always re-upload it. But this is the final product. So let me know what you guys think of this process. And I'm curious to see what you guys think of the image, but more specifically, the new outpainting tool. Thanks for watching.